My name is Brandy, and I am in fact an art student here at Jefferson College. This, if I asked you what all of these people had in common, you might say they're painters at first glance, and then you might say they're artists. And you'll see my name is up there, which is really weird. But what they all have in common is that they all suffer from diagnosable mental illnesses, every single one of them. A few that I'd like to talk about this evening. Jackson Pollock was riddled with depression and anxiety throughout his entire career. Van Gogh, Pablo Picasso also struggled throughout their lives, not just once they were famous. These things began as they were young children, and they didn't necessarily have a way to talk about it or discuss things or even know really sometimes what it was that they were going through. When I was in high school, I was riddled with anxiety. I was bullied. I was awkward. I felt alone. And eventually, I was diagnosed with depression. And I didn't really have any way to deal with that. I didn't know what it really meant. I felt broken. I felt useless, unwanted. And I turned to my art as a way to distract myself, to escape from my everyday life and my own personal demons that I was fighting. I would use it to avoid friends. I would use it to avoid my family, my school, just about everything. And then, in doing my art, I realized that I could confront some of the issues that I was dealing with. And eventually, over time, it helped me understand what it was that I wanted to do, which was overcome. Depression, among Americans, there's 26% over the age of 18. That's about 1 in 4, which is a really high number. And so I'm gonna show a few images. They're not too graphic or anything, but I just wanted everybody to know. These are a few of the artists that I have looked to over the years when I realized that I wanted my art to say something. I wanted it to start conversations. They both struggle with mental illness, and I decided to do a series a few years back that put into a picture what almost happened to me, how my story almost ended. And in doing that, I was able to come out and have conversations with people that I never thought I'd be able to stand up and talk to anybody about. The great thing about art, though, and opening the door to having those conversations, is that there's also amazing art that's being created that is uplifting and inspiring and whimsical and silly. This is Galwin, my garden gnome. I'm quite fond of Galwin. We went on an adventure for about 6 months. I drug him around with me just about everywhere I went. Literally everywhere I went. And these are a few of the other artists that were in that first slide. Some of the uplifting things. Many of them are known for their art that is very dark and dreary, their topics of death and demons and those sorts of things. But as you can see, many of them later in their lives, but they all had amazing things that are beautiful and inspiring. And what's fabulous about that is that not only in creating the art that opens the door to have the conversations, we have these arts that can move us to be uplifted when we're feeling down. Sometimes when we're down, we get into that dark place, and creating an art that is about that is therapeutic, but sometimes just doing the silly whimsical stuff gets us in a better place. and it helps us have these conversations. NAMI, the National Alliance on Mental Health, fantastic. If this in any way this evening has sparked any kind of interest in you to have a conversation to break stigma or deal with anything that you've been dealing with, fantastic to contact and